Hi, I'm James Matthews Paul for Output Magazine, and I'm here at Screen Media Expo 2011 with Paul Farrow, who's HP's Digital Signage Business Development Manager for EMEA. And Paul, I just wanted to, first of all, ask you about the relationship between HP and Scala that's been announced and how that's represented at this show.
Okay, excellent. We started a relationship with Scala about 18 months ago, looking at how we could develop a solution to bring to market for small, medium business. We spent about 8 months developing an immediate player appliance, which we've now delivered to market in November last year. The solution itself is very simple. It's aimed at small, medium business who predominantly do not have an IT department or a marketing department. So we have a product called Quick Start from Scala. We pre-install the software on one of our media players, and we basically supply that through our indirect channels, distribution partners in the UK and the Netherlands currently. We're about to expand that into the rest of the European market. The way this product works is very simple. It takes away the IT requirement for most SMBs in the respect that you plug it in, it boots up, it goes through an installation process, and 5 minutes and 30 seconds after booting up, you're actually using the software. So it's very user-friendly in that respect.
Excellent. And analytics is obviously a very important part of digital signage software these days. Mm-hmm. And I know that you're demonstrating some analytics software on the stand. Yes. Would you mind just showing that to us while we're here?
Yeah, I'd love to. Okay. So, you know, analytics is all about reacting to somebody who might be standing in front of a screen. So what we have here at the moment is on the top screen you can see that it's capturing the information about my age and my gender, and once it's captured that information it puts it into the software and detects that there's two males looking at the screen and we're between the ages of 16 and 34 for yourself, and I'm probably going to come in at 35 to 64. What that allows advertisers and retailers to do is when you walk into a store, the screen detects the age and gender and then produces content on screen for that particular person. So for instance, if I walked into a retail store and I stood in front of the screen, it would know I'm a certain age group and I'm a male, and it would probably put information on there for golf clubs or sports cars, because I can afford them at my age. Sorry, you can't.
Not yet.
No. So equally, what it also does is it retains certain amounts of data so that I know as the store owner that I had a certain demographic in my store in front of, let's say, the men's clothing department. At 3 o'clock, there's more people there than what there is for my age group at 9 a.m. So I can tailor my messaging going forward to target the right demographic at the right time of day.
And that obviously can tie in for businesses with their stock considerations, their logistics and that sort of thing.
Very much so.
Now there's obviously a bigger question about ethics in the capturing of this kind of data.
Right.
I know that European privacy law, for example, is just starting to consider it and just starting to develop on that sort of front. How is HP considering data capture? Is information about personal identity stored, for example, and what happens to the data when it's been incorporated into the analytics?
Okay, that's a really good question, and we take ethics very, very seriously at HP. Firstly, the information it's capturing, it's not taking a photograph of you and I. It's just doing a face recognition of our features and determining what our age group is and what our gender might be. As soon as we walk away from the screen, that content is deleted, it's not retained. We wouldn't at any time endorse, obviously, a product that suddenly took a snapshot of your face, because that's then personal to you. These systems have been looked at from a security perspective for both the customer and for the owner of the deployment. So I can assure you now and your readers that effectively this information is just about face recognition and not taking a photograph, and it definitely doesn't retain any information personal to you or I once we walk away from the screen.
I think that's very important to get across as this technology develops. Paul, thank you very much for talking to Output, and I hope you have a great time at the rest of Screen Media Expo.
Thank you very much.